children.
Began to sound. I want the game to discuss, 'cause at the end of time comes around. Titan shot the mountains. We have just passed through Redding and on our way up the hill to Mount Shasta City towards Weed, where we'll turn off on Highway 97 and head north on 97. But a little construction going on the road, and we're making good time, so we'll probably get to camp with plenty of daylight, and should be just absolutely perfect for setting up and getting everything organized. As you can see, that big tall case on top of Jake's truck, we're gonna have to organize and get off the top of his truck before we hit the trail. Might be tonight, or it might be further down the road tomorrow night, or sometime later, but before we get onto the trail, we're gonna have to cut his height by probably a foot or more. Anyway, yeah, doing excellent time. Making decent time. Had a couple of pit stops, nothing major, but as we come around the corner, we're going to see the beautiful vista of that's Mount Shasta, beautiful Mount Shasta. Here we are, just pulled in, getting set up for our first night camping. We are in Oregon, not far off of Highway 97, near Chiloquin, a little north of Chiloquin. Getting everything set up, getting our tent put up, fire pit dug, and ready to tackle the evening. Get some good sleep tonight. Part ways here. He's gonna head to Seattle, and I'm gonna go pick Steve up. Here we go. And here we are, pulling up at Steve's place. Remember it from last year. And he's ready.
It was just before nightfall, and we ended up waking in our campground familiar to Steve and I from last year's trip.
Alright, here we are. Rolling up through to Hope, BC. Spent the night in the Wild Rose campground. Jake had a bit of a snafu getting through the border crossing, but nothing that didn't keep him from getting to camp by 11:30 at night.
From Hope, we headed north on the town side of Iowa, coming on the paper with a plan.
Boston Bell for breakfast.
right, just passed through Sylvia's truck stop and on our way to NASCO. We're going to go through NASCO up to the trailhead that direction.
Getting ready to break camp. We spent the night here just off of the highway and getting ready to head towards the beginning of the trail.
It's actually going to do the river crossing again, but backwards.
So far, the trail is easy and can be accomplished in 3 hours. However, our second river crossing is the first thing that the trail is going to be After I stopped at lunch in the meadow, the trail began to deteriorate quickly. There were a lot of rocks and some patches of standing water. Jake and I have planned this moment for quite a while. Too bad Steve has to have friends like us. As Steve just set up, Cody and I do as well.
bad joke.
I'm just sitting here, I got time, it's clear to see, from up here, the world seems small, you can see it.
About halfway through our first day, we felt like we were the only ones on the trail. But that wasn't the case.
Required us to spot one another through a Cody Besler story portion of the trail. We also began noticing Jake's low range. It was still too high for slower obstacles, and we started smelling burning clutch radio. Right. Ooh, the reverend lost the war.
a little brush thing. As morning broke, we began breaking camp and checking our vehicles.
With anything mechanical, it's important to fix any problem while it's there.
So good morning. We made an epic journey from the trail head right off the main road all the way to Kluskoyle Lake yesterday. It was about a little over four and a half hours it took us. It wasn't very wet. It was very, very rocky. Lots of areas where we had to spot one another, as you well saw. Today we broke camp right around quarter after 10 a.m. We're still on the trail going around Kluskoyle Lake. The deep river. Crossing is coming up here later this morning, so we'll be ready for that one for sure. But so far so good. Glorious little campground. We all caught fish. It was not very hard fishing. It was just a great little spot. We had a few neighbors right next to us from Prince George. They came down for the long weekend to do a little fishing. They drug a fishing boat in with them. It was amazing that they got down the trail that we were really struggling with a fishing boat tied behind them. It was pretty amazing, but they made it. They did a little fishing yesterday. They didn't have any luck, but we sure did from shore right near camp.
Not very well. In reality, we did expect more water on the first day, and for some reason, I felt like it was coming.
having had a scary experience with the last two, we decided to get our wizarding wands out for the next. At this point, we began to enter a long series of burn areas. This destruction is a result of several forest fires sprung out over the last 10 years or so. In 2018, when Steve and I were traveling up to the Arctic, I told this to many people, we could have dumped a 5-gallon jug of gasoline on the forest floor anywhere where we saw it.
About this trail, it is a narrow one. My mid-size pickup, Nissan Frontier, 2014. It is just about as wide as you'd want to bring through here. Full-size pickup or SUV, you'd be doing a lot more work just widening it out wide enough to get through in a lot of places. Jake's truck is the 87 Toyota pickup, 4x4 obviously, but it's narrow enough. It's probably a good 6+ inches narrower than my truck. And that makes a lot of difference. You'll see on the video that some places I actually struggle with where he breezes through pretty easily. But that's just the nature of this trail. So we've been traveling through a burn area here and on our way to Pan Phillips Crossing. We've been in it for probably a good half an hour, 45 minutes. It seems to be getting worse and worse, but obviously people have been down this trail ahead of us sometime this season, this year. Fortunately, we're coming a little later in the season, so anybody that's come down here has already cleared a lot of the trees. So we've been very lucky so far. Starting to get a little wet in the ground. Nothing as far as bogs or mud is concerned. Just a little damp here and there than we experienced yesterday or at the beginning of this morning. So.
river crossing at the Bradt waterway. We continue pressing forward, watching diligently for the trail that is supposed to be to our left. Steve, who is also a navigator, is almost certain we have somehow missed it as the moon passed the afternoon. The note card we got from the motorcycle riders yesterday was that there was pretty little in the way of tree removal going forward. So they didn't need to turn them off.
Scare him, Rookie?
The long haul is an unknown threat. The reality was, we only needed to cause a dozen or so times throughout the boat. They feed these muscle power that removes smaller branches about double that amount.
Yeah! it.
Got it. So we just finished going through the last part of the burn, along from basically the tail, the northwest, I guess, corner of the park. Just basically, just got into the trees again, the unburned forest. It's a beautiful sight after probably, I don't know, three plus hours of going through that burn. Lots of brush, lots of debris. We had to get out several times. It was not a heck of a lot of fun, but we're enjoying it nonetheless.
We also picked up on a few of the property and different cabins that we let out to keep the cabins here. If you're a fisherman or woman, this area has world-class trout fishing and some waterfowl. This is a world-class fishing lodge. The lodge that we thought was very reasonable rate and can accommodate small or large groups. If this is something that interests you, feel free to contact them. Thanks again, William Teresa, for your hospitality and income and sale. Unfortunately, Wayne's intel concerns Steve's earlier concerns, but he has passed the trail down between another captain, so we were forced to head back to the rest of the time. What this really meant that we were going to have to get across the second bridge again. We felt a little better about it the second time, knowing that it at least supported our chance. The dilemma for us, as Wayne has indicated, that the crossing would not be doable due to the incredible amount of rain. After deliberating whether we could bypass the dilemma across the bridge, we decided to at least go and see if the crossing was doable. We ended up finding the trail down to the crossing. With Wayne's directions, we knew where to walk for it. We had to cut the track out right to the edge of the water, and after a quick visual survey, I chose to follow a line across the river that other groups have taken.
Okay, the big river crossing, here we go. Any last words?
And Meadow Crossing. Let's get
into it. Hey, aim for the other side.
Blessed be the rain.
The brightest stars quickly burn away. Our spark was brief, like the trail beyond a place. Could be lame. A heart so pure. Presents all around. Well, can you hear the music? Hear the sound? Yeah. The brightest stars quickly burn away. Our spark was brief, like the trail beyond a plain.
Well, that's the air cleaner. We'll see if that works. Get across the river.
I'm thinking somebody's gonna leave it there. Get a disaster, that's the only way to do.
Give it back to me. Lovely presents all around. Well, can you hear the music? Hear the sound? Yeah. The brightest stars quit.
Wow, that was an epic drive. Awesome. You didn't have to turn back up, do anything. You took a better line than I did. It was just a truly epic drive.
I saw that the ridge where the rapids are there, and I figured there's a bar all the way across that, and that's what I aimed for, and I found it, got across. 31s.
31 inch tires, guys. Good job.
Thank you.
We started out a day with a good breakfast and had this guy come check to see what we were up to. He left us as quickly as he had come, and we had no excuse not to get back on the trail and make tracks.
All right, just left our third camp.
All right, I think I'm ready to roll.
10-4, we're gonna get going right now. So just leaving camp here, we hiked ahead and cleared the trail ahead of us. We just did the Pan Meadow crossing last night, just right around dinner time. So we stayed in the meadow right beside the beaver pond. It was a little buggy to start with, but as the evening wore on, the bugs disappeared. It was an awesome evening, a little cool at night. But all in all, it was a great little camp spot, and we're looking forward to getting on the right side of the trail here.
We'd walk ahead with a saw cutter and turn forward and change the depth. About a quarter to three quarters of an hour at a time down the trail. Then we just drop the saw, walk back, draw it out. Exactly what 95% of us normally look like to us. You're absolutely right. A lot of manual labor and miles of walking.
Did about maybe a mile worth of cutting, came back for the trucks, probably not even a mile, maybe a half mile. And do a lot of trail maintenance today. Figure nobody's been through crossing this year, because nothing up here was cut fresh, so.
Yeah, we just got done clearing out the track here. It doesn't even look like a track. Looks like a lot of small trees are growing up over this trail. Certainly nobody's gone down this trail this year. We have not seen any kind of fresh track, fresh cuts on any of the wood. So that kind of means to me that it might have been a year or two since the last group came through here. Certainly the river crossing was a lot different than a lot of the other videos we've seen of the trail and the river crossing being done. This portion of the trail, most people haven't done a video detailing, so I can't really tell you how much resistance they've come up on, but we're having to cut about a quarter of a mile ahead each time. Stop, bring the vehicles up, cut a quarter of a mile, then stop and repeat. But this is a known aspect of the trail. We know that this is the this is what we were going to expect. That's right why we came equipped with two saws and all of the equipment to maintain and keep them up.
So this is where we got to, and we'll stop here for a minute.
Yeah.
We came across this little hole, and the first glance, it didn't look like much. But it had some bigger rocks on the outside, so it looked really impactful well in the time.
Yeah, it's a rocky bottom, so just take your time. There's a couple of rocks on the exit there that you might bang into if you're going fast.
figure me out, you might be a better name for this trail. I get more miles than a nice good place on this trip than all other four-wheeling trips combined.
We're up into the clear cut now. That was a long morning of cutting and tree removal from the trail. Not so much since we got onto the clear cut, for obvious reasons, no trees here. But it is a little tricky to keep track of where the trail is and where it goes. It's fairly indistinguishable from anything else.
As a person driving a lead vehicle, it's tough but not impossible to make out the trail until this point. Steve and I got out to walk and hopefully pick up the trail again. Turns out we were really close to the logging service road. We would follow this service road to the trail a few miles down.
Okay, just got onto the main road here, looking to pick up the trail a few kilometers down. It was a pretty hectic morning. Lots of tree removal, lots of small mud holes and bogs and so forth, but nothing really serious. So. We're a little sore after this morning's extent of chainsaw work and log removal, but all in all, we're excited to be on to the next stage of this trip. So, just turned back onto the trail from the main service road there that the loggers use. This is a pretty nice road, very well maintained. Just cruised down it, found the
the trail again further down, maybe 5 miles or so from where we came onto the road, three to five. Anyway, we're excited to get back down towards the lakes and the rivers, and hopefully not a lot of clearing going forward.